Welcome back to the channel, and finally doing the Kona, the Lava Dome, the cheap 80 quid eBay bike. She's now about to get upgraded with these parts, mostly XT. Let's have a look. Here we go, so we've got 737 chain set. Drive side is lovely. Non-drive is a bit shagged because that square taper is looking a bit round. These threads are looking a bit suspect. Worst case, if we can't do anything with that non-drive side, I'll just polish up the black one, take off the paint, it'll be fine. Tektro brakes, because cheap. Tektro things, because they're blue. Dicomp canty levers, because the original Kona ones have got a tiny bit there where the extension is screwing. Rubs on your finger, really annoying. So didn't want to get a matching one of them. Got some of them, they're crap, wanted to replace them. What are we on to next? Control sticks, because they're the coolest Byrons ever. 737 rear, 737 front. Pretty sure that's the bottom pull, 28.6, yep. So that will go straight on there, no problem. God knows what that is. Yeah, that's a lot. Let's focus and get it on. Here she is on the operating table. Let's start undoing stuff. Oh, that mech that I thought was junk is actually STX. Not that bad. That one. Oh, that's gonna make... This is where it starts to get interesting. The old, chain set, is it going to be stuck, is it not? If you forgot, pedals off first. Would have regretted that. Shifted, just can't do it one-handed very well. God, a few people that had the tripod suggestion were definitely right. But yeah, that's come off the drive side. Just thinking, should I bother taking the bottom bracket out and grease it all up? Oh, that was good. Same story with that one. Nice and easy. Obviously I did it all off camera. I haven't just done it by hand. It wasn't that easy. So props to the original owner or whoever slung the bike together using a bit of grease on there. Good job. That is awesome. So I just, with two hands, just had a tiny bit of movement out of the bottom bracket. Oh, I'm really happy with that. So I can finish the rest off one-handed. There's nothing really wrong with the bottom bracket, but oops. Whilst I've got the bike apart, I might as well. If I can get a bottom bracket, I might as well stick a new one in there. State of that. Probably won't focus. Probably hear one of the kids screaming in the background. yeah, that is rusty. That's really rusty. Let's have a look inside here. Oh, that is also rusty. Although, there's nothing terminal in the frame. It's just surface rust. But enough to get a bottom bracket stuck, that's for sure. I was lucky. And that's that bit out. There we go, underneath the rust. She is a 68mm shell. And you can just about see on the axle, 110.
But which bit?
That that is to fix lots of different bits on bikes. It's adjustable. Looking forward to getting these off. These are manky. Yeah, you can help me. You can swing a spanner at this bit down here if you like. Alright, let's get these horrible things gone. Yeah, it's nice to get stuff like this off. Look at that. Got some help. You helping me give it a polish? That's alright, just do the bottom bits. Good job, thanks. We're getting there. We'll go back on. Now for the bars. As much as I don't like these, I think all the faff with the shims and everything, it's just a bit unnecessary. I'd rather have a bar that just was the right size. I'm going to keep them until a titanium bar comes up. Keep that safe, it's bloody hard to find. Nice bit of rust. Started to panic a bit then. Freed off the bolt and tried to turn it, nothing. But shoved the long screwdriver down there. Couple of taps with the mallet. I must have got the wedge moving, and yeah, we've got a bit of movement now. Out comes that. Good thing about these impact headsets is once you've undone that, look, the collar nut, this whole thing just unscrews, and then your forks drop out. Crush the old thing. That's better. Bit of proper 90s Purple bring. Cool sticker, we always have one, but see ya. I think that was that came on a sticker pack in MB UK. Don't know what that crap is holding the seat post on, but looks like part QR and then part bolt. So, taking the forks off, sanded back some of the bits that the rust was potentially a bit more than surface, just to check, mainly here, and all the metal's good underneath, so that's a relief. But trying to stay away from giving this thing a full repaint, I want it to stay original. Sort of all this sort of stuff tells a cool story. So just gonna clear coat over the top of it like that, just a couple of coats, mainly to stop the bare metal rusting. So it's the next day, and we've had to come over to Taunton nice and early in the morning ish 9:30 to the Taunton branch of On Your Bike, and I'm getting a bottom bracket, hopefully. So there we go. They didn't have a brand new one, but they did have this used one, which was only a fiver, and it's really smooth. There we go, just back from picking up our bargain bottom bracket BB. I haven't started doing anything to the paint on the frame yet. But I really wanted to get a bottom bracket fitted, just in case it gets wet or damp. Don't want any corrosion in any of these bits and bobs, so just going to grease her up and get the bottom bracket in now. In she goes. Okay, so that was wrong. This bit didn't go in first. The bottom bracket goes in the drive side. This is an FSA bottom bracket. That's both sides on. Looks alright. bang this on. Yeah, after it's tightened up, might be alright. Cool. So that was really rusty. Brought it up alright. What I've been doing is a little pot of water, a sanding pad that is probably, I think it's around about 800 grit rate maybe. Get it a bit wet, like that, a bit more wet. Take that bit for example, give it a little sand off, quite gently. Don't go too hard, just a little bit, just to take the rust staining off of the that area. And then to polish up the clear coat again that's been scratched, use a bit of this metal polish. It's quite abrasive, and a cloth, and then it comes up like that. Done it in quite a few places now. It's starting to look quite shiny from a distance. There we go. So I've just gone over the whole thing with this sanding pad. So it looks horrendous at this stage. Metal polish, and just bring up the lacquer. I know that the scratches that pad leaves will polish out with this stuff. So it should look nice and shiny after. And then I'll give it a coat of wax. So there we go. Bit of a finished polishing it with that autosole, and just gave it a coat of wax. And well, to me, it looks totally different. Yeah. Perfecto. Still looks a bit crappy, but I found a more subtle bolt to go on there. But a load of grease. And she goes. Chain set. Whoop, lovely jubbly. Looks nice. The other side I've done up really tight because the square taper bit on the arm is a little bit rounded. Mech on. XD. I was about to stick the rear mech on and it's a bit crudded up, so get all the jockey wheels off and give it a bit of a clean up first before it goes on. Lovely jubbly. That's a bit nicer. Typically it started raining, but that's not going to stop us. XT mech is on. Boing boing. So another thing I'm recycling is the legendary Impact headset. Just has its Impact writing on there. It was Kona's way of sort of making the forks easy to change out without having to. Yeah, this isn't in bad shape. Just going to try and clear out some of the old gunky grease, put some new in. This isn't very rusty, so this would be absolutely fine to use again. To be fair, I wouldn't really use anything else on a P2 fork. Be rude to put a normal headset in. That's the all important seal that sits on the bottom of the headset. There's a name. I'm going to use some of this limited edition elbow grease provided kindly by our future not yet sponsors. Come on, elbow grease. Get it all over that. Let that work in. I think my cloth is probably going to put more dirt on than it's going to take off. But yeah, I'll get that clean and get some fresh grease on. Rain started again, but just thought I'd show that all important little rubber seal there in place.
We've greased top and bottom, all the cups, and that seal as well, the important seal, greased up, greased all in there. And then screw the collar on, bloody raining out there again. Oh, that's feeling smooth. Really is a cracking build, this. I didn't video it, but I had the wedge was stuck in the steer of the fork. Just had to hammer that out, but got a bit more up and down adjustability on this now. Looking at the wrong camera. Bars on with that pesky bracket. Don't like it, need to get rid of it. Starting to take shape now. Got those, really glad I shaved those grips. Got those on. Got to go full on anodized bling with those bridges. Took out the rusty old bolt in the impact stem as well. Stuck a purple one in. So that's going to add to the anodized bling. No colour coordination whatsoever. Green, blue, purple. Yeah, it's getting there. Got the back ones on. I hate setting up bloody canties, so I'm going to have to do that. Yes, it's all getting there. Wheels on, a few cables on. Going for grey cables. Thought they looked pretty good. Beats the normal black. And we're going for full on colour overload now. Going all in. Got some blue skewers as well to go on it. So yeah, she's getting there. Wow, look at that. So I think on day three now of messing around with this. Obviously it hasn't taken me 3 days. It's been in between the little bit of time off work I've had, spending time with the family and whatnot, doing this in between. Yeah, I had loads of colourful bits like brake blocks and bridges, different coloured cable caps. I thought I'd add it all on there. There's no real thought to colour coordination, just looks cool. I can always swap it back out again, put some more subtle colours on if it looks rubbish. So yeah, all I've really got to do now is the dreaded job of adjusting the canties, stick some bar ends on, go through, tighten up all the bolts that I probably missed, and then that is it. It's good to go. So that's the dreaded job of the brake setup. Just chopped these off. Now for my favourite bits. Yes. Although I reckon I could do with some colourful bar ends now. All done. 1994 lava dome finished. Yeah, I will in a minute. I've got, start off with the bad, the Tektro brakes. They'll do for now. It's better than what was on there before, which didn't work. Got the tyres. They're definitely nearly past their best. But I'll keep using them until another set come up. I'm not too keen on putting anything too expensive on there, because I like to use this one, and I don't really want to trash expensive new old stock tyres, so just keep using these for a while. That's the old green SL. Quite cool. Gave the post a polish, put a nut on that. But I'll try and sort that out with something a bit prettier. I will in a minute. XT drivetrain. From Mac 2. Wouldn't mind upgrading the wheels sometimes. It's only got an STX hub. But they'll do for now. Paint's come up amazingly well. Forks are probably the worst. Alright, well, in a minute. Control sticks on. Scruffy thumbies. These were pretty knackered. They're all gunked up inside. So I soaked them in hot soapy water for a while. Flushed them out with degreaser. Well, the grips that are saved. Obsessed with them. Dicom levers. Yeah, anyway, I think we all know the spec by now, so I won't bother going through it all again. Everything's got a good old coating of grease all over it, ready to use for many more years. Oh yeah, thanks for watching if you got this far. I always forget to say stuff like that. It is appreciated. We're on the verge now of getting some sort of money from YouTube. I don't know how it all works, but I think I have to get another 100 or so watch hours to meet the criteria to get something. I don't know what. So watch 100 hours worth and then I can find out and let you know what I get. So yeah, that's it. I think that's it. Yeah, thanks for watching this far, and who knows what we're going to get next.